ना जुदा होंगे हम कभी खुशी कभी गम.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
This is for anybody that needs a reminder. You can wear whatever you want, however you want. It does not matter what's flattering, what you should be wearing. None of that. None of that's real. 2020, I want you guys to get rid of all that from your head. If you want to wear a crop top, wear a crop top. You want to wear a bikini, wear a bikini. You want to wear a bodysuit and have high-waisted pants on like me, do it, because you can and you should and you're beautiful right now. The end. Do it, okay?
My junior year of high school, I told my counselor that I wanted to graduate early for multiple times that school year, and he was like, I'm with you on this, but I really don't want you to graduate early because you're going to miss your senior year experience. At the end of the year, we'd been talking about it the entire year, and everything seemed to be flowing fine, at least on my end. And I was speaking to the head counselor because I had an internship at the end of the year with a law firm, and she wanted my opinion, and I was making small talk with her, and I told her how I was going to be graduating early this year. And she was like, what do you mean? I'm the head counselor. I would have known if you were going to be graduating early. And I was like, yeah, I've been talking to my counselor about it the entire school year. She was like, have you filled out the paperwork? I was like, what paperwork? She's like, the paperwork that you and your parents signed in order to order your diploma. It's due, or diplomas are literally due today, and we need your paperwork. And I was like, no, my counselor never told me about any paperwork. He never even told me I had to ask my parents. My parents are fine with it, but he never told me that. And then she was like, well, I'm gonna give you the paperwork today. I'm gonna illegally put your name down, like literally put your name down, but you have to bring the paperwork back tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Kwaku. I'm a music artist from Boston. Last week I posted a video about my family wanting me to quit music, and y'all shared it like crazy. Although the video isn't super viral, you guys gave my dream some hope. So if you like the song playing, or just feel like helping me out, share this, like this, or follow me, because I got a lot more songs on the way, and I really want to prove my family wrong this summer.
Why is it so bad that people are rioting? Why do so many of y'all love to talk in people's comments saying this isn't what MLK would have wanted? Please be quiet. Because what are we supposed to do? Sit at home and wait for the police to do something? We've seen tons and tons of evidence of police not doing anything, giving people paid administrative leave after murdering human beings because of their skin tone. So what are we supposed to do? Wait at home? No, we're going out and rioting. And stop using MLK's words against us, because I can bet every single thing in my life that he will be protecting those people rioting a lot more than you and your little TikTok and Twitter fingers on the internet telling black people what their leader was saying. Please shut up, okay? Educate yourself and get out of our comments.
This is why we all need to be boycotting Ben & Jerry's.
As much as everyone is praising Ben & Jerry's for their activism and speaking out about the Black Lives Matter movement and racism in America,
We need to address the fact that Ben & Jerry's is pro-Israel and actively Zionist. The Israeli military, IDF, trains the U.S. police force. You know how that officer, Derek Chauvin, put his knee on George Floyd's neck and murdered him? That practice is used by Israeli soldiers towards Palestinians. How can Ben & Jerry's advocate to abolish and dismantle the U.S. police system, yet support IDF, the very force that trains the U.S. police? We need to boycott Ben & Jerry's.
I got $500 in cash in case they don't take MX. She wanted to see me, so now I'm headed to the annex.
And it went like...
I got $500 in cash in case they don't take MX. She wanted to see me, so now I'm headed to the annex.
The youngest child anthem. Hi, I am the youngest child. I act all nice and sweet. So when it's time to get my wit, you'll never have me beat. I stand in the shadow of my sisters and my brothers. I'm charming and creative and called cute by all the mothers. I don't remember that, 'cause I wasn't born yet. Hand-me-downs are a lot of what I get. Compared to my siblings, I may be the dumbest, but I get all the attention because I am the youngest.
This is why you need to be kind to yourself. A while back, when I was cleaning my room, I found one of my journals that I used to write when I was a kid. This is like 3rd grade to 6th grade. My first reaction was, "Dear Lord, what am I gonna find in here?" The first entries were basically about my day, but then I started talking about all of my crushes and how much I liked them. And I thought, oh my god. And I started whining about stupid feelings too. And I was talking to one of my friends while I was doing it, and I was laughing at it. Like, I was reading entries and I was like, this is so stupid. But then something weird happened. I couldn't describe it, but a part of me wanted to cry. It kind of caught me off guard for a second, but then I realized what was happening. Essentially, I was a full adult looking into a child's diary and making fun of him for it. And the child inside me was crying. And I realized that that journal wasn't mine anymore. It belonged to a kid who was brave enough to write down feelings he couldn't understand. Someone who didn't want to be judged, even by me. Haven't touched it since, but I hope to earn that trust back.
And we made a new friend, and after about 2 hours of playing together, I asked who he was, and my son said, "That's his cousin."
I was just thinking, Indian Americans are so dependent on their parents, at least me. I'm 18 and I have never done my own laundry. I can't cook anything but Maggie. I rely on my parents for their money. Like, I don't use my own money ever. They still cook my lunch every morning for school. How am I gonna make it in this world?
So there's this trend on TikTok where you have to make an ugly face on three. Ready? Why are you not on three? Ready? One, two. You guys, I signed on three.
Okay,
you little bitch.
Okay, Nabella, how do you deal with the constant cyberbullying on you, your size, your appearance, your body? And the thing is, I learned something early on that freed me that I think might free you too. And that is that happy people don't say hurtful things. Someone that's successful and winning is not wasting their time online making somebody else feel bad about themselves. They're too busy winning. They're too busy succeeding. They're too busy focusing on their own grind. So if someone is leaving you a comment and is making you feel awful about yourself, remember, it's not you. It's never been about you. It's them.
I got $500 in cash in case they don't take MX. She wanted to see me, so now I'm headed to the